name's Jason Rayo. I'm currently the Director for International Affairs at the American Society for Microbiology, the oldest and largest society of life scientists in the world. I'm also the advisory chair of the smallest and newest nonprofit in the health sciences called Health Security Partners. I'm also a graduate of the Johns Hopkins University Biochemistry, Cellular, and Molecular Biology training program. Well, I followed what some would call a non-traditional career path. After finishing my PhD here at Johns Hopkins, I went on and did a postdoc at the NIH. And then I took a turn. I decided to try a fellowship at AAAS, a AAAS diplomacy fellowship. And I was placed at the State Department in the Office of Cooperative Threat Reduction. And there I pursued an almost 10-year career path in international science and security, working on non-proliferation programs, bioterrorism programs, but also supporting international science cooperation between the U.S. And many other nations. From there, I worked on the Hill for a year as a Brookings Fellow, and the last few years of my career with the government, I actually worked at the White House in the Office of Science and Technology Policy as an advisor on global engagement and international science. I was fortunate to work as a senior policy advisor to President Obama in the crazy world of politics at the White House. And from there I went back, as I mentioned, to the American Society for Microbiology, where I direct their international affairs. Well, I love science policy. Just in the same way that I felt that I was advancing, science and our field of knowledge as a basic researcher, science policy is an opportunity to make the world a better place at a much higher level. Policy today, more than ever before, is really in need of data, of what we call evidence-based policymaking. And scientists really are essential to making that happen. Well, it's different for everyone and really depends on the organization or institution that you're working for. Inside the government, a day-to-day science policy advisor does many of the same tasks that you might do now in terms of lots of email communication, attending meetings. I think what's important is that you're also doing a lot of reading about the issues. You're understanding the nuances of an issue. You're writing very succinct memos about the issue to policymakers. And you're trying to get at the heart of the issue through phone calls, conversations, and a new set of communications that you're not normally doing as a scientist. But day to day, that's what we do. If you stop and think about the greatest challenges we face today as a nation and as a global community, climate change, energy shortages, disease eradication, biodiversity, environmental remediation, these are all challenges that are firmly rooted in science. Science provides the solution. And yet we look at our policymakers and there's not a lot of scientists amongst them. And so getting into science policy and really providing evidence in our policymaking is needed now more than ever. And I can think would only become increasingly important and thus provide an increasing number of opportunities for PhDs to get involved and provide their expertise into policymaking. My advice there is the best thing you could do is really to find someone working in the area you're interested in and connect with them and ask their advice. From there, they will have very specific suggestions on what to do, what opportunities there might be to participate in a meeting, or what organizations might be looking for an intern, et cetera. Of course, there are also fellowship and internship and training opportunities that help PhDs transition into different careers, such as the AAAS policy fellowships. The National Academies of Science have a few. Some of the scientific societies have an increased number of opportunities there. So looking into each one of those is great. But again, I'd say find a mentor, find someone working in the area, and network from there.